A spelling bee is a place where spellers congregate. All the verbomaniacs, philomaths, and bibliophiles who love to spell.
I'm Joya Das at the MetLife South Asian Spelling Bee, now in its fourth year. And we're just getting a sense from the kids what exactly the mood is like.
At the beginning, I asked my dad to sign me up, and then I started studying straight from there.
And I was really excited. And when I get to come here, I get to do what I like a lot, spelling. And I also get to meet a lot of my old friends from other bees.
He loves the adrenaline rush that comes with it. I'm a nervous wreck, but he enjoys it.
Okay, so Dad, do you know CPR in case your wife passes out?
You never know, because the spelling bee is like a random game. So you prepare your best, but just hope for the best.
In 2011, we've seen a very interesting mix of spellers. We've had top-notch spellers come and participate in our regionals, but have not made it to the finals. And we've got newcomers to the spelling bees and to our spelling bee who have not made it to any other finals in the past, make it to our finals. There's a 50-50 mix this year around, where we have the 50% of the repeats and the top series sellers, and 50% of them who are doing it for the first time and are really involved in it.
So are you nervous today?
Yeah, because it's my first spelling bee and I haven't done this before, so I'm kind of nervous.
This is my first time doing it, so it was like a whole new thing for me.
It gets a bit like unnerving up there.
Yeah, I'm nervous, but whatever the result, I'm just here to have fun.
We've all come so far with the same goal, so it's kind of nerve-wracking, but it's also quite interesting.
I feel kind of less jittery now. I'm like less nervous, and I'm more kind of confident.
I'm gonna try to maintain my composure and just hope I don't go nuts.
So is this your first time competing?
No, I was at the Nationals before in 2009.
So what was the word that knocked you out the last time?
Sangfro.
Do you know how to spell that now?
Yeah. Sangfroid.
Like you're never going to forget how to spell that ever again.
Yeah.
Well, I lost out on the word picnoxylic. I spelled picnoxylic, but it's picnoxylic.
You're not competing with your other spellers, because the word, when it's given to you, you're competing with the word. If you know the word, you win. You win against the word.
So maybe you're actually competing with yourself.
Possibly, you're right.
So if I get like a horrible word, and like the next guy gets like a really easy word, he's gonna win even if he knew less words than me, so it doesn't really matter.
What's the hardest word you've ever spelled?
The hardest word I had to spell was quincunx. It's something that people use in geometry.
Janana. It's a Sanskrit word meaning knowledge.
Like the hardest words are from French, and so I think one of them that I spelled in the spelling bee was feuilleton.
What does that mean?
I have no idea.
The biggest word in the dictionary, pneumono-ultramicroscopic silicovolcanoconiosis.
Hippopotamonstrosesquipedalian.
And that means what?
All but relating to extremely long words.
Very appropriate for today.
Yeah.
I expect to see a lot of tough words.
So what's your strategy if you get a word today that you don't know?
I'm just gonna like use what I know and like try to put it together and try to come up with the word and just take my best guess.
You know, you look for certain parts in a word that are in words that you already know.
What does the word etymology mean?
It's kind of how you trace a word back to its original language, because most words pass through many languages before entering English.
What rules the word follows from its language?
Using those clues about the typical nature of the languages, you can piece together a word you don't even know. You ask for the language of origin if you get the word solar, and they would say Latin, because it comes from the Latin root sol, meaning sun. And so if you know how to spell that root, you know how to spell the word. Well, what I do when I study words is I look at a word, I close my eyes, try to see the word, and then I spell it out loud.
I've been studying language patterns and roots.
I find a word that I don't know, and then I like study the word, and then I quiz myself, and my parents quiz me.
My sister quizzed me a lot, and my entire family. We made flashcards out of the words I missed, and we studied roots and language of origins.
What is the most exciting thing about being here today?
Like meeting everyone and spelling, of course.
I like to see everybody because most of these people I've met from previous spelling bees, and so we're all good friends.
It's just learning the words and then like using them in everyday life and like confusing people with them, and it's really funny when they don't know what you're saying.
I just like spelling words.
I've scoped out everyone and everyone is competition.
There's a lot of good spellers out there, and I really didn't come here to win. I came here to learn new words and have fun, so.
Because no one's a loser. You know, even if you study 10 words, 100 words, you're that many words stronger and your vocabulary's better.
It's gonna be good. I know that for sure.
We are backstage with the kids just to get a sense of how tense this atmosphere really is.
The mood right now is getting a little tense. We're just in our second round. We've lost a few spellers. So now it kind of kicks up from the third round onwards. It gets difficult from here on. But I think they're all up for the challenge. They've all prepared very hard. And by the end of it, we're going to get the best speller from the community.
Yeah, heart's beating faster every time somebody spells.
Yeah.
And closer and closer in my turn.
What's going through your head?
I'm just like, okay, pardon me if I say it, but I'm like hoping they'll miss every time. Okay, so I got zooplankton. Yeah, I knew it. I used to read a lot of books about animals and stuff, and it's a zoology term. It's like tiny little animals in the ocean. So I've known it for a long time.
I had to spell the word chordal, spelled C-H-O-R-D-A-L. Well, it's kind of tense because the competition is fierce and, well, the words are difficult and we just gotta do our best.
It's a spelling bee, so it's a tough competition out there. And yeah. Everybody's doing their best. They've studied hard. We should be proud of everybody that they've accomplished so much and been here.
Plexodont. It's spelled P-L-E-X-O-D-O-N-T. I spelled it P-L-E-X-I-D-O-N-T. And so I just kind of asked the questions just for the sake of it. I didn't really pay attention.
Your heart just breaks because you know that spelling bees can be tough because one letter can just, you know, throw you out. That's why to win a championship like this is truly a remarkable accomplishment.
Kids are what it matters. They're our future. And encouraging the parents to invest in their kids, especially in the spelling bee contest.
Everyone is my favorite.
For next year, we're going to start with producing our program today, and it's going to be aired on Sony Entertainment Television, and that officially kicks off our season for the next year, which is 2012. And next year, we're going to Seattle as our added city, so we'll have 11 cities and 22 contestants vying for a $10,000 prize.
When do you sleep?
Tonight.
That wraps up our coverage from backstage at the 2011 MetLife South Asian Spelling Bee. I'm Joya Doss.